and welcome to the January edition of Platts SBB Global Market Outlook. This month the title is European Mills Buck the Global Pricing Trend on a Macroeconomic Perfect Storm. In this edition, we look at what's been happening in December and early January. The key development was that scrap prices rebounded upwards after the recent weakness, while iron ore levels ended slightly down from the start of December, moving above $70 a dry metric tonne at the turn of the year before falling downwards again. Scrap prices rebounded in Turkey and US during December, but European levels remained more stable. In the US, flats prices dropped during December and then fell further despite the stronger general economy. European coil prices, meanwhile, slipped during December but then consolidated and looked likely to strengthen despite the weaker economic data in this region. Asian coil prices fell further during December and early January. Longs prices in Europe stabilised in December, but they were weaker in Asia before dropping further in January, while rebar prices in US were reduced by the producers in January. So firstly, looking at the production figures from World Steel Association, which showed a small decline in daily production in December, a slight rise in actual tonnage from November, that's a shorter month. Also, we now have total figures for annual output, where the production rose in the three key regions and globally overall, but by comparatively small percentages. China produced sharply more in the month of December and 822.7 million tonnes in the full year. That's a rise of 1.5%. China's output growth is slower than recent years, as previously anticipated by many observers. China still accounted for around half of global output in 2014. Europe, that's EU28, saw even higher growth of 1.8% year on year to 169.2 million tonnes for the year. The biggest increases in output in France, while production rose in Germany, Netherlands and the UK compared to 2013. US production has been pretty consistent on a monthly basis and is 1.7% up on output annually. This gives a global total of almost 1.637 billion tonnes for 2014. It's 1.1% higher than last year, though we do wait to see if China's output is restated upwards as last year's was. So, looking at flat products. In the US, hot rolled coil spot market dropped sharply in December as the market worried about overcapacity and imports, and spot prices fell further in early January. Inventories were cut back and have not been rebuilt in the new year as prices have been falling. In Europe, spot prices weakened slightly during late December, but stabilised in early January as demand looked to firm and sentiment was rising, despite the economic situation. Buyers are likely to be looking to make new orders, while producers can be encouraged by the weaker euro. In Asia, regional flats prices continue to drop steadily during December and early January, as demand remained weaker than usual for Q4 and extremely competitive offers were available from Chinese mills and other regional suppliers. Prices here have continued to fall, while demand is likely to be on hold until after Chinese New Year in mid-February. Next, long products. Prices for rebar were weaker in Asia during December and fell heavily in early January as sentiment followed Chinese domestic pricing itself had dropped again in January. Prices slipped in Europe during December and have then consolidated in early January. In US, rebar prices held steady in December, but producers then dropped their levels as the market came under pressure from more imports and slower demand. And now, raw materials, iron ore. Prices for iodex 62% rebounded in December, moving above $70 a dry metric ton late in the month before falling back again during January. Prices have gone up and down and returned to the level of a month earlier by mid-January. Chinese buyers can still pick and choose when to buy, and there are plenty of offers of material from the major Australian miners. The seasonal weather problems in both Australia and Brazil have not yet occurred this year. And then raw materials, scrap. US prices for shredded material recovered in early December as prices increased in buy week and have risen further in early January before consolidating later in the month. Following the export prices into Turkey and other markets in Asia initially meant the US market price was under pressure, but expectations of lower inflows meant domestic prices rose. Turkish import prices have rebounded in December and early January, though they've weakened later. European prices were steady in euros during December, but have then been firmer in early January. Asian import prices for scrap also dropped during December and fell again in early January as international levels came under pressure. And finally, coming up in mid-February is Chinese New Year. We would like to wish all our viewers a happy and prosperous Year of the Goat.